CNN has suspended Chris Cuomo indefinitely pending further evaluation after new documents revealed he contacted media sources to help gather information for his brother, former Governor Andrew Cuomo, as he faced sexual harassment allegations. CNN alleges they were unaware of the full extent of Chris's involvement in his brother's defense, saying in part, "When Chris admitted to us that he had offered advice to his brother's staff, he broke our rules and we acknowledged that publicly. However, these documents point to a greater level of involvement in his brother's efforts than we previously knew."
According to Variety, Chris Cuomo is CNN's most popular anchor, drawing the biggest audiences of all the network's programming. His show, Cuomo Primetime, averaged just short of 960,000 nightly viewers last quarter. Here to weigh in on Cuomo's future and what this means for CNN is Briahna Joy Gray. She's the host of the Bad Faith podcast and former national press secretary for the Bernie Sanders campaign. Briahna, welcome.
Thank you, Robbie.
So, I mean, I don't know what else they could do, right? At this point, they had to put him on leave, and I don't see how he can possibly come back. He clearly misled viewers when he said that he was, you know, kind of just there, support for his brother, maybe a little bit of advice, but this goes pretty well beyond that, don't you think?
Yeah, I mean, what the new documents show is that he was explicitly looking for information to give his brother a heads up on the process of the allegations that were coming down the pike. Remember, at the time, there were 11 women accusing Andrew Cuomo of misconduct. And at a certain point, there was new information coming out at quite a rapid clip. And what Chris Cuomo was endeavoring to do was to use his position and access as a journalist to get that information to his brother and to help him, you know, workshop his message and provide cover, as you will. At the same time, you know, this is in the greater context of the Cuomo brothers being a kind of a stand-up routine at a certain point at the height of the COVID pandemic. And I would remind you that a lot of people think that Cuomo should have been censored, you know, reprimanded, or even fired over that and his handling of the COVID pandemic and the nursing home scandal, right, which actually resulted in many, many, many deaths of elderly New Yorkers. So, you know, it took this Me Too context to actually bring him down, and not even bring him down, just to have him suspended. So we'll see what actually happens next, given that Jeffrey Toobin, who's in a very similar situation on the same network, is now back as though nothing ever happened.
And Briahna, I think there's another layer to this, and I wanted to try out a theory on you. One of the things that journalists do, a lot of journalists do, that has always bothered me, is they gripe publicly to brands, like, and particularly airlines. And, you know, they will tag an airline that their, you know, their flight is delayed, or they don't like their seat, or, you know, whatever grief or grievance they have while they're traveling.
And you're calling me out right now, Ryan.
Oh my God.
This is a pretty deep cut.
If Robbie does this, we will discuss this later. And so I've always kind of wondered, what is it about this that bothers me? And I think what it is that, and I'll deal with it. And I think what it is that the public invests a certain amount of trust in journalists and a certain amount of power in journalists. But that is power that they're supposed to be using for the public's benefit. Like, you know, in the United States, the First Amendment and the reverence that we have for the press, even as it isn't exactly reflected in polls lately, you know, has given reporters and journalists a measure of credibility, but they're supposed to be deploying it for the public's benefit. And so when they use it for their own personal gain, I feel like it's a betrayal of that public trust. And I think Cuomo was doing that kind of times a thousand here. Like, the reason that he had access to this information, it's not because he's a particularly wonderful person. It's because he was a primetime host at a cable news outlet. You're supposed to use that power for the public's benefit, not for your own personal benefit. And I think in that betrayal is the place where he's going to have a hard time recovering from.
Yeah, I was listening to some commentary, and there's definitely a large number of people who basically take the line that, you know, family comes first. I would do whatever I needed to do to help protect my brother. At the end of the day, wouldn't you do the same? And I think what that analysis misses is that, one, I mean, you can do it, but you're going to have to suffer the consequences, and that's what's happening now. But more importantly, that the information that Chris Cuomo had did not come by him randomly. It came because of the position of access he was in as a journalist. And to me, the analogy is more akin to, you know, if a police officer or somebody else invested with the public trust were colluding with a defendant or a public official or what have you, against the interest of the public, as you say, Ryan. And I think that given the enormity of the scandals that happened over the course of the last year, both the COVID nursing home scandal and this Me Too scandal, and given that CNN itself pushed the relationship between the brothers as a selling point, putting them on air together and giving them giant props. At one point, there was a giant Q-tip prop that the brothers were using, and there was the joke was that, oh my gosh, you got a big nose, and here's a big Q-tip because we got to take COVID tests because people are dying. Like, I don't even know what the gag is. That CNN was really trying to play off of the closeness of that relationship also makes this whole dynamic very unsavory.
But I think this is exactly why people, I think this is why Chris Cuomo is actually going to be back. I don't think that this suspension is going to last for too long. And I think it's because people are actually very forgiving of him on this particular issue. And even I can feel sympathy for the guy, right? I say, oh, well, you know, if you put yourself in his position and it's your family member, and, you know, I think a lot of people could say, I probably would run cover for my family. And again, of course, he's now suffering the consequences of that. But I think because it's a relatable sin that people are all willing to say, you know, I maybe would have done the exact same thing. I think that that is why the public will be very forgiving of him on this. This is very different than himself being accused of any sort of sexual allegations. Although I think Don Lemon and I, there's been a bit of that going on over there, but
there have been, you know, some low level accusations kind of thrown his way.
His former editor accused him of inappropriate conduct at a Christmas party.
Oh, that's right. The she wrote a whole thing for the New York Times about it.
So this is why I don't think that it's going to stick for too long. I do think him being the most popular person on CNN, mixed with this being a sympathetic sin, mixed with him not being the person who actually committed, you know, the actual grievance. So I don't know. I think what he did was wrong. Obviously, he shouldn't be a journalist. He shouldn't be presenting the news if he can't be unbiased. Yeah. But I think he'll be back.
I was surprised to find out he's the most popular person at CNN, frankly. But
I was a little too. But like, I think that Kim is right. I think that if the Jeffrey Toobin situation is any indication, he'll be back. Now, I think that what Chris Cuomo did and was complicit in is much worse than Jeffrey Toobin. I mean, reasonable minds can disagree on that. But, you know, I would like to see more of a focus on the kind of journalistic malpractice around the nursing home scandal, to be honest, in addition to this Me Too context. Because at that point, Chris Cuomo had a role in actually covering and exposing, he potentially could have been exposing his brother's misconduct by having more hard-hitting interviews that actually got to the bottom of what was going on in these nursing homes in New York. Instead of doing this tomfoolery with oversized props and basically literally providing cover on air for his brother's malfeasance.
Yeah.
Former President Trump couldn't resist getting in on the pile-on. Last night, he released a statement saying, quote, great news for television viewers. They have just suspended Chris Cuomo indefinitely. The big question is, was it because of his horrendous ratings, which in all fairness have permeated CNN and MSDNC, or was it because his brother is no longer governor? Probably both. In any event, Fredo is gone, finishing with what Cuomo had called an anti-Italian slur. Trump celebrating the good news for CNN viewers. He's joking, but Briahna, could you argue that this is good for CNN in the sense that it will force it to reevaluate what it's doing? Because its charts are heading only in one direction, with them kind of desperately hoping that for Trump's return.
Yeah, well, you know, I just interviewed on Bad Faith Podcast Batya Unger-Sargon, who wrote this book about media bias and how the elite media has failed to capture the interests of the working class. And one of the sections of the book talks about the benefit that Trump offer to the networks, and how every single time he said something like this, it would be a boon for MSNBC and CNN. Gosh, Trump's got me pronouncing MSNBC wrong. But, you know, and there is a lot of, it's likely that there will be a rush of sympathy from viewers to want to support CNN and Chris Cuomo, rather, because of this scandal and because Trump chose to weigh in. He is America's favorite foil, so we'll see what happens.
They're going to replace him with the FBI. This hour of news brought to you by the FBI. Briahna, thanks for being with us. We appreciate it.
Like every other
Thank
hour.
You.
Like every other hour. More Rising right after this. Stay with us.